friends, welcome or welcome back. So today I am doing a special video. I actually got this idea because mainly like in the book community, I started over on my Bookstagram because I love taking pictures and obviously I love books. And another thing that I really love is fashion. I love creating outfits surrounding like the cover of a book. Those are some of my favorite pictures to take over on Bookstagram. So I got the idea because I was watching this show on Netflix called Emily in Paris, and it was actually all over Bookstagram. I was surprised because the show has nothing to do about books. It's not a book to film adaptation or anything. I think the only correlation to like the book community is the fact that Lily Collins has been in so many like adaptations for books, like City of Bones and Love, Rosie, and I'm sure she's been in other adaptations in the past. But that's the only correlation between this show called Emily in Paris and the book community. But the reason why I started watching it is because it was on everybody's Instagram stories and everybody was loving it and everyone was recommending me to watch it. So if you haven't watched Emily in Paris, this show is about this girl who is an American. She lives in the United States and she's offered this opportunity to go work in Paris for like a marketing firm. But she's American and she doesn't really accustom to the ways of the French. She thinks like her way is like the right way to do things, and she's great at her job. But yeah, it's just kind of her adventures and how she makes friends and boyfriends, her job. She doesn't have a very easy time in Paris. It's an incredible show. I really, really love like the plot and everything. It's great. But the best thing about the show, Emily in Paris, is the fashion. All of the fashion, I just loved. Every outfit was iconic. I wouldn't say that the fashion slash style of Emily and Emily in Paris is my style specifically, but some of those outfits are just so iconic. Like, they live in my mind rent-free. So I've been wanting to recreate some of those outfits for Bookstagram or do something with it. I actually tried to recreate one of her outfits that is going to be featured in this video. I'm actually wearing the blazer for the set from the picture in this video. But yes, there's 5 outfits that I loved from the show that I want to take those outfits and kind of find book covers that are very similar to like the outfit and the colors and everything, and read those books. I know that there's no correlation like whether I'm gonna like a book or not just because they match an outfit from a TV show, but I thought it was a fun idea. I'm gonna try to recreate some of these outfits and the books that I choose to read for those outfits. I'm gonna try to recreate some pictures. So, I'm gonna show you guys my Pinterest board now. It has the 5 outfits that I want to use for this video. I haven't really given much thought of what books I'm gonna read, like matching them with the outfits, but we will look at my Goodreads TBR and choose that for me now. Scooching over so I can put my screen record here. So I'm gonna start screen recording in a minute. Let me find it. 3, 2, 1, screen recording. Okay, cool. So we're gonna go to my Pinterest board. I'm gonna be looking down so much because my phone. And we're gonna go over to my Pinterest board, and I have the Emily in Paris outfits board. So here are the 5 outfits. So let's start with this one. This one is the one that I'm wearing the blazer right now. I actually tried to recreate this outfit already on my Bookstagram. I did not have the red beret, so I think I used like, I should have put my phone on Do Not Disturb. How do I do that? I don't know how to do that. Oh my gosh. Anyway, hopefully we don't get too many notifications. But For this outfit, I didn't have the red beret, so what I did was grab, I think it's Six of Crows or Crooked Kingdom, which the heart bag is a red cover. So I used that for this. I will post the picture somewhere in this video, maybe later on when I actually read the book that I'm choosing for this outfit. But I, like I said, I bought like a little set just like hers. Mine is a skirt and not a short. But I think this is the outfit that most people think about when they think Emily in Paris. This is like the iconic outfit. I'm not sure if it's just like the cover or if it just really screams Paris. I'm not sure, but this one is one of the iconic outfits. Let's do this one. So this one, it's not something that I would ever wear in my life. Maybe the green jacket that she's wearing, like the leather green jacket, would be something that I would wear. But I really love like the combo of pink and the different prints and the purple. I love this outfit so much. Next one is this one. This one, that's not Emily. This is a supporting character from the Emily in Paris show. Her name is Camille. I loved like the layering and the plaid and the mesh balloon sleeve. I think this outfit is really cute. I'm going to be recreating this. I've been looking around for stuff that's similar to this. And I'm going to be recreating this outfit soon. So we'll see what we pick for that. And then here's another green number. She's wearing like a little plaid skirt with the green jacket, and then again she loves to match, like mix and match different prints, like she's wearing flowers on her neck and then plaid and then a pop of color. So I like that one as well. And then the last one that I really really love is this pink, this hot pink number. I actually hate that purse that she has on, but I don't remember this purse on the show, so I think this is just like a in-between scenes picture that was taken. But this hot pink number, it's like everything, like the heels, the freaking socks, the coat and the skirt and the sweater, it's just everything. Yeah, I would never wear anything like this. I think the only piece from this that I would wear would be the coat, and I would probably get some looks because I live in Cleveland. So that's the last one. So these are all the five outfits that I want to find some book covers that kind of look like the outfit. So now we're going to go over to my Goodreads shelves. Is that what they're called? Yeah, we're going to go over to my Goodreads shelves. So you're gonna see that I have my one to read, and then I have another shelf down here that says really want to read, because I kind of fucked up my want to read shelf, because back in the day I used to enter like every single giveaway on Goodreads, and back in the day it used to just add it to your want to read shelf. So my want to read shelf isn't very accurate. So yeah, I have like 100 books on my actual TBR, which is this little shelf called Really Want to Read. So I'm gonna look through it really quick just to get some ideas. Oh, you know what? I'm actually gonna cheat because I have a buddy read coming up with my friends, Isabel and Camila, and we're buddy reading from Blood and Ash, and I already had in my mind that the plaid and red outfit was gonna be the book, was going to be from Blood and Ash. So that's that, I believe. Everything else, I don't know. There goes my boyfriend. I don't know what I'll be reading. But for the first one, which is the plaid and the red, I'm gonna be reading from Blood and Ash because I need to read that this month. And I think the colors, oh my gosh, this is taking forever. The colors fit pretty well, like the red and then there's black. So that's gonna be that one. Let's see. Let's do the hot pink next, which is at the bottom. I can't remember if I have any hot pink outfits like on my TBR, honestly. Let's look through. There's a little bit of pink on Such a Fun Age, but it's also very blue, which I didn't really want. One to watch It's also like hot pink, but it again, it has blue. Bunny. Ooh, bunny. And a bunny has black. So that kind of matches more the outfit. Ooh, I think if I don't find anything else, hot pink. I know it has a little bit of orange, but the black kind of like ties into the outfit, I feel like. So I think if I don't see anything else, I think we're gonna go with bunny. Because that's hot pink and it has the black. Yeah, I think we're gonna go with bunny for that outfit, honestly. And I've been dying to read Bunny. It's one of Books and Lala's favorite, so I'm really excited to read it. See, so all of these, like, that's hot pink and Instant Karma, kinda, but it has a lot of more blue than the actual hot pink that I want for the outfit. So honestly, I think we're gonna go with Bunny. Yeah, that's the end of my TBR. So we're gonna go with Bunny for the hot pink look, and then we have From Blood and Ash. And then we can move on to this green outfit, and it's a green and a little bit of black, has a little bit of white. So let's see what we can find on my TBR for that. I feel like I'm gonna have a lot of green books. There's Sorcery of Thorns, but that's kind of more aqua than green. I want like a green like what she's wearing. So let's look through my TBR. There's My Sister's a Serial Killer. My Sister's a Serial Killer is more of like a neon green. A Song of Rates and Ruin. That's a good one. That looks very similar. Let's see. Ooh, The Inheritance Games. Hi friends, so my camera actually cut me off, so I'm gonna start screen recording again, and the only thing that this cut out was that I actually chose The Inheritance Games for that green outfit that we saw, the green outfit with the plaid at the bottom. So this outfit that should be on your screen right here now, I chose The Inheritance Games. So now I was going to be moving on to this outfit right here, which is Camille's outfit, and we're going to go back to my TBR and look for something similar to it. So this one, I feel like we're going to have more options because it's very like, I mean, it has a little bit of black, it has a lot of brown and cream, and like there's a little bit of white, so maybe I'm gonna try to find something with like stars, because she has like stars on her shirt. So we're gonna look through and see if we have any options. Let us the Wicker King looks, it has a little bit more gold than her outfit does, but the Wicker King looks like a good option. Let's keep going. Okay. Oh no. I think I found it. I think The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. Because it has little stars. And it has like the brown and like the cream color. It has a little bit more black. But I like The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue a bit more for this outfit than The Wicker King. That might be an unpopular opinion. But yes, I think I'm gonna go with The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. I also want to read books that I actually want to read. Like, I don't want this video to be, like, a drag. Like, I don't want, you know, I want to actually read some books that I want to read. So, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue has been one that has been on my TBR for a little bit. So, I think we're gonna pick The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue for that outfit. And then we have one more outfit left, which is this one. I think this one's gonna be a little bit harder to find something because it's green, it's pink, it has a little bit of purple, and I actually want to be able to find all of these colors in one outfit. So let's start at the top of my TBR. Why do I always refresh it accidentally? Okay, so we need, so that has green, has a little bit of purple, and I'm talking about the Gilded Wolves, has a little bit of green and purple. I kind of want a little bit more purple than that. Let's go down more. The Giver of... No, it has too much yellow. The Giver of Stars by JoJo Moyes has too much yellow. Let's keep going down. My phone is so slow. I currently don't have Wi-Fi at my house, so I've been filming this and everything with my data, so that's fun. Oh my gosh. Oh, hold on. That is perfect. The House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune. Look at, I'm sorry, but that is perfect. It has pink and blue. It has the green. I think that's it. I think the House in the Cerulean Sea. I'm not even going to finish looking at my TBR. So for the pink number, we're reading Bunny. Then for this one, we're reading From Blood and Ash. This one, we're reading The Inheritance Games. This one, we're reading Addie LaRue. And then for this one, we found the perfect book, and we're reading The House in Cerulean Sea. I'm actually really excited about this TBR. I'm going to stop screen recording now. So I'm actually really excited about that TBR. Yeah, I'm going to either buy some books. I think I own a couple of them. So I'm gonna go buy some books, see if I have a couple of them. I'm gonna look for some stuff online to recreate some outfits. And I think the next clip will be me reading the first book for this video. Not sure what that will be, but this was fun, like figuring it out, like a TBR, like at the moment and actually filming it. Cause usually I come into this like already knowing what I'm gonna read. So this was fun. Yeah, I'm excited to find all these books and read them and show you some pictures of some outfit recreations. Yeah, I'll see you guys later. Hi friends, it's a couple of weeks later and I got all of the books in. So I actually realized that I never explained what any of these books are about. So I'm gonna very briefly go over what these books are about. And then the next clip should be just my ratings and my thoughts and photo recreations of the outfits. So I'm going to start with The House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune, which is the green, purple, pink outfit of Emily. This one I've heard only but great things. It's magic and it's about caseworkers and it's about this orphanage. And I know there's a queer love story. That's about all I know about this book, and that's kind of how I want to go into this book, just not knowing anything. I know it has magic, I know there's a queer love story, and it's about an orphanage with, like, kids that have magic, but that's all I know, and that's all I'm going to say about it. The next book is the book that I'm going to be buddy reading with my friends, which is From Blood and Ash. I know this is, like, a high fantasy novel. It's about this girl who is like the maiden and she's like the chosen one for the gods. I'm pretty sure that she has to like hide her face, but she's like chosen as the maiden for this ritual, but she actually doesn't know what the ritual like entails, so she doesn't even know if she's gonna die or if she's gonna live. So she goes out one night and she's not supposed to go out of the castle or anything, and she goes out to like a bar and stuff happens, but she just kind of wants to live because she doesn't know if she's gonna be alive after this ritual. But it's actually so much more than that, but that's kind of like the main premise. But I know it's high fantasy, it's steamy, it's a romance, and I'm super excited. The next book is The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab, and this is for Camille's outfit. And actually, From Blood and Ash is the plaid and red outfit, but The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue is about this girl who makes a contract, a deal with a demon, and pretty much she kind of words it badly and the demon kind of just does whatever he wants with what she said. So for the rest of her life, for like 300 years, anybody she ever meets doesn't remember her, but then one day comes around and somebody does. So that's pretty much the premise for this one. The next book is Bunny by Mona Awad. I'm actually After I read this and I get my thoughts completely together, I'm probably going to recommend this to my sister because this book really reminds me of Heathers, the movie Heathers, which is like a cult classic type of movie. And this book is about this girl who's in college, and there's this like preppy type of group of girls who call each other Bunny, and they give her an invitation for like a party, and just weird shit starts happening. So I'm excited to read it. It reminds me of the Heathers movie a lot. So I'm excited to get my thoughts. I'm pretty sure this would be kind of a book that my sister would really enjoy. And the last book, I actually have no idea what this book's about. So that one's The Inheritance Games by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. I'm sure there's an inheritance that people are fighting over. Secret passages, elaborate riddles, billions at stake, let the games begin. Avery Grams has a plan for a better future, survive high school, win a scholarship, and get out. But her luck changes in an instant when billionaire Tobias Hawthorne dies and leaves her virtually his entire fortune. The only catch, Avery must move into his sprawling mansion full of secret passages, riddles, and codes. Interesting. We'll see how I like this. Those were all the books that I'm going to be reading next. I just wanted to give brief summaries because I forgot to do that. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. Hi. I just finished From Blood and Ash by Jennifer L. Armentrout. So like I said, I wanted to get this into my TBR because I was buddy reading this with Cammy and Issa. So I was kind of low-key cheating for the outfits. I'm going to put the outfit here for where I matched this book with. But I just finished this and this was insane. Like, the ending is insane. I'm not going to lie. This book is 600 pages long and the first 400 pages were pretty boring for me. I'm sorry. I know a lot of other people are obsessed with this book, but for me, this was a 4 out of 5 stars. I'm not gonna go into too much depth because, like I said, the ratings for these books don't really matter because they don't really correlate to, like, the show or the outfit from the show. So I just wanted to share, like, my rating for the book. But again, this book was 600 pages long, and I started getting really into it in, like, the page 400-ish. So I did really like it because of the ending, and I do think that from the ending, the next book is gonna be like reminiscent to A Court of Mist and Fury by Sarah J. Maas, which is one of my favorite fantasy books of all time. So I'm super excited to pick up the sequel for this series. But next up, I think I'm gonna be picking up The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, which is the outfit that I chose. Oh my god, I forgot her name. I can't remember her name, but it's that one outfit from the other girl that it's not Emily. But you'll see later. Hi friends. So I'm currently joining in some sprints and I just finished The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. I'm going to post a picture here of the outfit that correlated to the book, the outfit that matched this book. I also just bought, like, this little, I don't know what to call it, like a jumper dress thing. I don't know. It looks exactly like the thing in this picture. So I'm going to try to recreate this outfit, and hopefully I do that with enough time and I'll post it on my Instagram or on this video, if I have enough time. But I'm going to say this at the beginning of every rating for every book in this video. The rating literally does not matter. Like, my opinions and thoughts on these books don't matter because there's, like, no correlation between, like, the fact that these books match the same colors of outfits from Emily in Paris. But anyway, I just finished this. This was pretty average. It was meh. Really sick and tired of reading books that are just, like, average. I am currently giving this a 3.5 and I rounded it up to 4 stars because that's the nice thing to do. But sometimes there's some books that I just want, like, there's some books that are 3.5, but on Goodreads, they're just a 3-star, you know what I mean? Like, they don't deserve a 4-star. Yeah, this was pretty average. It was really like a love story slash romance with like soft fantasy, if that makes sense. And I don't really vibe with romance books anymore. So that was that. It was a 3.5 for me. And I think I mentioned that I was joining some reading sprints. And I'm gonna start Bunny by Mona Awad. I just joined Mare's from Mare Reads her sprints, and she was excited that I was picking this up. I'm excited to pick it up as well because it's one of Kayla's from Books and Lala's favorites. So it's something different, weird, just something different from what I usually read. So I'm hoping to really like this. But yeah, I'm gonna pick this up and I will show my rating and the outfit that this book correlated to later on. Bye. Hi friends. I just finished Bunny by Mona Awad. I finished it like an hour ago, and then I've just been sitting in bed like reading reviews and analysis and articles about this book because the moment I finished it, I was like, I don't know what I just read. So I went over to Goodreads just now and I rated it a 2-star. I didn't really like it. It was really, really weird. I enjoyed it mostly at the beginning, and then like hitting the halfway mark, I just didn't know where the book was going. I was a little lost. I didn't really like the sense of like, what is it called? Like, I was just confused, and the story was just very confusing. I don't know. I keep thinking that if this book was in the form of like a Jordan Peele horror movie, that I would really enjoy it. I mean, there's just some books that I've read that are really low rated for me, but then I watched the adaptation for it. Like, Normal People, I hated the book, loved the show. Bridgerton, The Duke and I didn't really like the book. I love the show. I feel like this book would be a better, for me, as a format, I think it would work better as like a movie than this book. Yeah, it was really weird. I didn't really know what it was trying to say. It just made me feel really stupid. Like, I feel like other people might have gotten more out of it and might have been like, yes, this is what Mona Awad is trying to say, but I just didn't really get it. It was just really weird, not my type of book. I know that a couple people that I know have read this and enjoyed it. It's just not my type of book, I guess. Yeah, so right now I'm rating this a 2-star, and next up I'm gonna be picking up the Inheritance Games as well. I am hoping to do a little recreation picture, outfit recreation for this book as well. So I'll be posting the picture here now if I got to that. And like I said, I'm picking up next the Inheritance Games. And I am going to be doing also a outfit photo recreation for that book. So, next clip should be me finishing up the Inheritance Games. See you guys later. Hi friends, I am no longer blonde. My hair is now reddish brown. The color that I put on my hair was called Cherry Cola. But I am joining some reading sprints that Mel Reads is hosting. She hosts every Friday at 7:30. And during the first sprint, I finished The Inheritance Games by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. So I absolutely loved this book. Haven't gone on my Goodreads yet to rate it, but this book is definitely going to be a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I really, really loved it. I definitely see the correlation that people make between this book and Knives Out. I also think that people that are fans of Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson would really enjoy this book. I was a bit skeptical going into it because I know that a lot of people had said that you either love or hate this book, but I'm really glad that I was on the side that really loved it. There's a lot of twists throughout the novel. I think the only reason why it's not a 5-star is because some of those twists were a bit underwhelming. But I really, really liked it. It ends in kind of like a cliffhanger. So I'm definitely going to be picking up the sequel for this book. I do think that by the time the sequel comes out, I'm going to forget a lot of the things that happened in this book. So hopefully somebody out there did a book review for this so I can watch that and get like a refresher on everything that happened. But I'm going to be putting the outfit recreation for the outfit for this book on the screen now. And sprints are still going, so I'm going to be picking up the last book for this video, which is The House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune. Super excited to pick this up. I definitely think that this could potentially be a 5-star read for me, but yeah. Yes, last book in the video. This is always exciting, so I will see you guys later with the rating. Bye! Hi friends! So I just finished The House in the Cerulean Sea, which was the last book for this video. And this was a 5 out of 5 stars for me. I really, really enjoyed it. I think I mentioned what this book is about, but it's kind of like an orphanage with magical children. And this caseworker goes up there just to see what the conditions of this orphanage are. And I just really loved it. There's like the found family trope. It's very character driven. Not a lot happens, but these characters just felt so real to me. Like they felt like real people. And you just love every single character in this novel. Like it was a lovely time. I really, really loved it. Like I said, 5 out of 5 stars. I did not recreate the outfit for this. I wish I could have, because that's one of my favorite outfits from Emily in Paris. But I think that is the end of this. I really enjoyed doing this video. I'm already planning on doing a similar video like this for another TV show that I love with some iconic outfits. So if you've made it this far, thank you. And if you have any recommendations of any TV shows or even a movie with iconic outfits that you think I should do next, please leave your recommendations down below. Subscribe. I think I just hit 500 subscribers today, which made me really happy. I'm hoping to reach 1k by July/August, because that's when I started last year. But yeah, I really loved doing this video and doing the outfits and everything. Next TV show outfit video, I'm gonna go hard on these outfit recreations. And I had a lot of fun. I'm already planning some videos out, and I hope that y'all enjoy them. So thank you for watching again, and I'll see you later. Bye!